Podcast. Cristo Rey Podcast. The Cristo Rey Podcast is coming at you. It's almost too good to be true. It's Women's History Month, so we gathered a bunch of Wonder Women to share their views.
Hey everyone, welcome back to another Cristo Rey Podcast. Today's episode is very special. This is our Women's History episode. Today I am joined by my co-host,
Rebecca. Hi guys.
And today we have some very special staff members with us, and I'll let them introduce themselves.
Hello, I'm Miss Dixon. I'm the PE teacher here. I am the head coach for volleyball and an assistant coach for track.
Hello everyone, and this is Mrs. Vallejo, your Spanish teacher.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Perlick. You may know me by my name, Miss Irby. I teach 9th grade English.
Hi, everyone. It's Miss Salimis, and I teach government and AP Gov.
Okay, well, I'll start off. What does Women's History Month mean to you?
Well, for me, one thing I wanted to bring attention to was when my mother was in high school in 1976, OSA sanctioned like girls' basketball. And remembering that there were certain things that and even our parents' lifetimes that did not exist. And what was pretty amazing is I kind of asked my mother about, like, what was that like? And she told me the girls' basketball coach was also the volleyball coach, the hockey coach, the softball coach, and the track coach. She had to coach all the girls' sports at Hartley or else they wouldn't have had it. And back then, it was definitely volunteer basis. And what was so amazing, the first year that OSA had a girls' basketball tournament, Hartley actually won. So they got inducted in the Hall of Fame for Ohio, but unfortunately with COVID, they haven't had the ceremony yet. Mm-hmm. But I just can't believe how close that is, because I'm somebody who went to states in volleyball and track, and I took it for granted because I thought this is how it's always been, when it actually hasn't. So history is a lot closer than we realize.
I think that's a really good point, because I knew that question was coming, what it means to us. And I have to be honest, and as a history teacher, this might be a bad thing to say, but it hasn't in my lifetime meant a whole lot to me. And I was thinking about why that is. And I think it's because I'm the generation after your mom and my mom. And so, like, my parents expected girls to do the, like, I played sports with my dad. I was on the sports teams. I did all that stuff. And I remember, and this will age me because I'm older than everyone here, there was a Marlo Thomas album called Free to Be You and Me. I could still sing every song on it, but the whole thing was about, like, equality between boys and girls, and, like, girls can do anything boys can do.
Every boy in this land grows to be his own man. In this land, every girl grows to be her own woman. Take my hand, come with me, where the children are free.
I was raised in a generation that already kind of had fought for that, and so, you know, I didn't have to fight for that, so I think that's part of the reason.
I'm sure it's not a big shock, but as an English teacher, I think Women's History Month means to me that more women have a voice, and I think it's probably telling, but my favorite book club is Reese Witherspoon's Hello Sunshine, that gives a voice to these women writers. And I think it's obviously a great thing to highlight different women's voices throughout this month.
And for the Spanish department, and according to my background too, we have seen a lot of difference on how we were raised when we were younger in the Hispanic cultures, starting by school life, that it was very important. I went to a girls' school until I was in high school, and my brother went to a boys' school until he was in high school. And then when we came to the U.S., you can see the difference of how you are raised. The boys will never enter the kitchen to do the dishes, but the girls are expected to do all this. We have amazing women in the Hispanic culture, like Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz, and she was a very, very intelligent woman, but she had to go to become a nun to be able to study and to be exposed to different books or different literature. Oh, we have Frida Kahlo with her paintings, but she actually is a statement in the Mexican culture and in the culture of the world as well, on how that the voice of the woman is important too.
I'm sure we can all agree. We know who like Abigail Adams is and Elizabeth Cady Stanton, some of the biggest idols in women's history. But a lot of people don't know about the smaller. I don't want to say less impactful, but less known people in women's history. So what do you have to say about that? Like, how should we be pushing that information out, and how should we be getting those names out of the lesser known women in history?
Well, everyone's looking at me since I'm the history teacher, so I'm in there. And yeah, and I was thinking about the fact that I said women's history wasn't important. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that it is important, but I think I took it for granted is what I'm saying. And so, of course, it's important to get more voices in there and not just hear about one or two women that you put up as, you know, just as same with African-American history. It should be all year long. It shouldn't just be in February. Women's History Month shouldn't just be in March. And the history books are changing, but they change slowly, and they change due to the advocacy of women and African-Americans and Hispanics who fight for representation in the history books. And that's why one of the things I try to teach my students is that they need to be active participants in the making and understanding of history, because there have been plenty of people over the years that would like to tell you what history means and who's important. And if you just kind of sit back and let that happen, then a whole lot of people will be left out. So you have to advocate, and you have to be an active learner. And so that's why your history class is very important.
Hi everyone, Elonga here. Lent began this Wednesday. To help us start off Lent strong, here's Mrs. Ghaffarzadeh with a special reflection.
Lent is a season that is full of invitation from God. He calls to each and every one of us to return to Him. Come back to me with all your heart. For God, that invitation is so easy. His greatest joy is His relationship with us, and He will always call us back. However, accepting that invitation isn't always easy. Am I worthy? Am I ready? Can I do it? We constantly question and judge ourselves. The beauty of God's invitation is that we don't have to be perfect, and we don't have to do it alone. He wants us to allow Him to walk with us on our journey. Letting Him do so is the first step. Lent is a time for us to accept God, let Him in, and allow Him to work in our lives, creating a new heart that is ready and worthy of Him.
I would say also, I love what Ms. Limas is saying about being part of the history. History is written every single day, and is written by us if we allow that to happen by participating in podcasts like this. So you guys are amazing women already that are leading our podcast today. And so you are making a statement and being here with us today and leading the podcast today. So I think women in general, the students here at Cristo Rey, you don't have to wait until that you're famous or that somebody recognizes you for this and for that, but that every single girl, every single woman can make a difference in just participating in school, in sports, in, I don't know, in an essay that you have to write and share what you think. I think everybody can, write history in their own circle, in their own life.
I definitely think that when I think of Women History Month, I think of women in some sort of like sisterhood and like a community that we can be a part of. I know I associate myself with this group called Proyecto Mariposas, which is a group that started in 2011 by this woman named Yahaira Perez. And so we basically, it's a group of young women and mothers for them to come like every Saturday, and it's been going as, and it's just been able to help girls be empowered by like who they are, like just as like women to feel some sense of community with each other. So I've been going there since I was like six, so I know it's very important to have like connected with your background and who you are.
Hi guys, Ujil here. On Tuesday, March 8th, from 3:15 to 3:55 in the chapel, Fashion Club will be hosting Miss Ellen Ellis, the admissions director from the Columbus College of Art and Design. The meeting is open to any student interested in art, art school, fashion, or CCAD.
I know that the school has kind of like a group like that named Rocks, and I know Miss Perlick used to run it, so I don't know if you want to talk about that, like your experience with the group and how like impactful it was for the girls, that you see like the change in them and
Yeah, so I think back to some of the things that Ms. Vallejo was saying, I think Rocks gives girls the confidence that sometimes they need in order to speak up, especially in a group. I think sometimes we're taught to just accept information or to be quiet, to be gentle, not to rock the boat. And sometimes that means that our voices are kind of run over. And to have the confidence to speak up, to take up space, I think is necessary, especially when we're young. And I think that Rocks does a really great job of teaching girls not only confidence, but to your point, community, because sometimes that's not easy amongst women. Because the things that we see in social media is often so catty and so dramatic, and that's not necessarily reflective of the relationships that we actually have. And so I think that, that program is really interesting because it teaches us how to advocate. It teaches us about how to form friendships, keep ourselves safe, but most importantly, how to speak up and advocate for ourselves.
I can definitely agree with that. Recently, me, my father, and my stepmom, we watched a documentary on Netflix about the infamous Tinder swindler. I'm talking about this right now. It's reminding me of that, how these women, they were using their voice, they were using the knowledge they knew to bring the world together and, you know, try and take down. And despite all of the negativity they were gaining, all the like upset comments and upsetting things people would say about them, they would continue pushing, and eventually they didn't get all of the revenge they wanted, but they still like were able to influence the world enough so that, you know, this guy was actually caught, and he was caught and he was sentenced. But I still think it was like all the negativity they were still gaining, it wasn't helping their situation. And, you know, I'm glad that they were able to stand on their own two feet eventually. And I'm glad that they were able to impact the world and help the world through their eyes, because there are also people who are commenting good things like, oh, these poor girls, you know, just stop saying this stuff about them.
Hey everyone, Nyjah here. Are you interested in science? Are you looking to join a club? Then why not join Science Club, a club about science? Come to room 317 right after school on March 9th for a resume building workshop presented by science majors from OSU. Any questions? Contact Mrs. Bauman. Until then, stay sciencey.
I know that here we also have Rocks, and then the program that Rebecca mentioned. Is there any other like programs or, you know, social events that we can also, that anybody can attend, where it was young women, old women, young mothers, old mothers, where they can attend so they can all come together and do this, become one as a community.
Well, as a head female coach of a sport, one thing that I like to kind of bring up is, you know, sports is somewhat still a new territory for women and girls, and having people take it seriously without the other side of making it about the attractiveness of women, because that's a big thing that sometimes happens in women's sports. And one thing I definitely believe with being a head coach is that I'm basically representing two girls, that you can be in a leadership role and do well and know what you're doing. Because even when I started out as a coach in track in like 2018, which seems so far away now, it was very interesting working with male coaches who constantly would challenge me, even though it's like, I know I'm right, I know what I'm doing. And it was so fascinating, despite all the attacks I got, I pushed through. And when I was proven right, nobody apologized. And it was accepting that I was not going to receive apology. It was just like, okay, I guess being right and the team being successful is what matters. But one thing I love seeing female coaches, head female coaches, just running and doing a really good job. Like sometimes I'll see somebody, even though we're competing, I'm just like, I'm rooting for you. I'm rooting for us. And so that's something that's been very important to me, because I think when you're not used to seeing women in leadership, you're more likely to question it, even if you are a girl, because you might be like, well, how do you know what you're talking about? Because one of my athletes, the first year I coached, always questioned me because the male coach kept feeding her information as a means to keep questioning me. And she was, of course, one of the people who didn't apologize when everything went well. So I thought, well, let me just use the example of, I know what I'm talking about, keep pushing through. And that's what I want girls to realize. Sometimes you're going to be in a situation where you're going to be questioned, not because of your ideas, your thoughts, or anything else, but that you're female and that's all that's needed to say you don't know what you're doing.
Hi guys, it's your girl Icy here. Over President's Day weekend, a group of Cristo Rey students attended the JSA convention at the Ohio State House. All the members did Cristo Rey proud with their participation, questions, and speeches. Seniors Merav, Serenity, and Omar all came away from the convention with Best Speaker Awards.
And I want you guys to realize you can push through, but you got to pick and choose your battles, and you have to realize that not everything is worth a fight. Some stuff was just better to let go. Like, I realized I didn't need to go around pointing, I told you so to people, but rather, okay, we're doing well, I'll accept that, let's move forward. But even after that, there was still a lot of questioning, and I thought, okay, I thought I proved myself, but keep pushing through. But I love seeing girls also gain confidence in sports. That's why I love having captains, because you're leading your girls, you're an example. And so I want girls who are in sports to realize this is a great time to build confidence. I built my confidence in sports, and to consider that that's a great way to go about it. And it's not even about being the best athlete either to build your confidence. It's that you work hard, you persevered, you are a great example to those that are younger than you if you've been in a program for a while. And even if you have a female coach, just kind of realizing that there's a little extra hurdles that we have to go through. Because I even remember being at a game explaining the rules to a ref, and he kind of laughed me off. And I'm thinking, no, this is what it is. But at the end of the game, the other ref was like, you were right, coach. And I'm thinking, why didn't you stand up for me to this other guy? Why are we arguing when we could have solved the problem sooner? But I just want, you know, give a little nod. And if you can support girl sports, definitely come out and just support us, because we don't get the same kind of respect as boys sports do. I mean, I even remember being in high school thinking, the girls, we're doing well, but yet the boys are not even doing half as well as us, but they're being celebrated. And I remember being like, we're the ones that are putting our school on the map and having people like realize like, oh, wow, we're great. But it's the boys just have to be half as good to get more recognition. So just a little shout out to anytime you're aware of girls playing, give them, you know, a little bit of support.
Hello, everyone. It's Najee again. As you already know, last Thursday, February 24th, Russia invaded Ukraine in an unprovoked attack. At Cristo Rey, we pray for peace in the world. Please join me in this prayer by Mark Liberton of the Fuller Theological Society. O Lord Jesus, servant and master, bringer of peace and reconciliation, with deep sorrow and concern, we cry out to you for the beginnings of this war now occurring in Ukraine. We long for you to arrest this violence and destruction, to bring this war to a just end, and for your protection for all innocent victims and everyone directly involved in military action in Ukraine and in Russia. Lord, in your mercy we pray. Amen.
Okay, so one thing I wanted to talk about was menstrual products and how personally for me I feel like it's not normalized, and like just like the conversation about it, I feel like most girls are like kept hush about it because it's disgusting in quotations, or just like something that I don't know is perceived as not normal even though it happens with every woman. So like, what do you guys feel about that? Do you think like growing up it was normalized? Do you think it's gotten better, like talking about it? Because honestly I feel like it's the same, and people, I mean, I feel like we have done progress talking about it, but I feel like it still should be normalized, especially to guys.
Can I ask a clarifying question?
Yes.
Were you asking about products or just like the menstrual cycle in general?
Yeah, both.
Okay. So this is, I almost wanted to start with, this is a bit of an overshare, except we're trying to normalize this, right? So when I was in the fifth grade, mm-hmm. we hadn't really talked about the menstrual cycle yet. And I remember I was sitting in class and I was sitting in a plastic chair, and I had gotten up from the chair and there was blood all over the chair, all over my pants, and all of the kids, including me, who had no idea what was going on, were just absolutely like
horrified,
yes. And I was horrified, and I ran to the bathroom. I thought I was dying, and they had to call my mom, and she came to the school and like slipped a pad underneath the door because I wouldn't open it. I was so upset. And she explained to me what a menstrual cycle was. Of course, 2 weeks later, the boys were separated into one room, the girls were separated into another room, and we all watched the movie, if you know what I mean. And so yes. As everybody's watching the movie, all of the girls start to turn around slowly and look at me like, oh, that's what happened, right? And it, for a long time, it was this source of shame. I was so ashamed of what had happened to me. And it really wasn't until I was a teacher and we had this lockdown drill, and it was an active shooter drill, and all the lights were off. We were all like huddled in the corner, and this girl wouldn't stop talking. And I was like, stop talking. This is to be taken seriously. Mm-hmm. The lights come on, and there's this like blood smear on the wall from where she had touched the back of her pants. And she didn't know what was going on. And I thought, we've come full circle. This is a time where we could actually allow this girl to feel shame like I did. But I recognized it for what it was. And I tried very hard to normalize that. Like, this is just something that happens. It is not a big deal. And I hope that she walked away from that with a different experience than I did. Because every woman goes through it. Maybe differently, but everybody does. And it was such an awesome gift to me that that did happen, because I was like, wait a minute, why did I feel so ashamed of that? You know? So hopefully that answered your question. But yeah, it is something that people don't really talk about. So
I think by menstrual products, I meant like tampons. Oh. You know, like the social contract of like virginity, and like how like I guess a tampon could take away that. But I feel like especially in the Hispanic community, there's a thing where like, I don't know, a lot of moms don't really allow their girls to like purchase tampons or anything like that because of the idea. But I know personally, like my mom just now like started like learning about more, and like she's very adapting to like new ideas and everything. So she's just now got an idea of like women wearing tampons. But before, like especially me, since I play a lot of sports, yeah. and like running with a pad on is so annoying. Like it's so. And then I recently found out about like tampons and like being accessible, since now we have like at the school and like other places. Like I know the other day I went to the Crew Stadium, and there's like a company called Flow or something like that, and it's red and it's like everywhere, and I've seen it on like different buildings like for free. So that's good for them. But just the idea that like I wasn't able to get a tampon, but when it could have helped me like all this time while running and like doing sports, and it's just like a life changer.
Hi Cougars, my name is Rita, and I'm here to promote the YWCA Duration Drive held by my club, the Social Justice Club, and Circe UNICEF. The YWCA is a family center here in Columbus, which is dedicated to eliminating racism, empowering women, and promoting justice and dignity for all. The YWCA family center here in Columbus has 50 families without homes and provides them with their daily essentials. With this drive, we hope to help reduce the lack of access to toiletry and menstrual products for people experiencing homelessness and raise awareness for this lack of access. All donations directly go to this organization. This donation drive will be held from February 28th to March 11th, so be sure to donate. Refer to the item list posted in the school hallways and found in your email that all correspond to a point total. The grade level with the most amount of points collected from collected items will win a dress on day for the grade. So be sure to donate, Cougars. Have a great day.
So I have a quick clarifying question. Will that also include like the menstrual cup where it can fit in front for? And I don't know if that does help. And I understand like now this is really I don't want to say uncomfortable because we are trying to normalize it now.
Well, I will think, ladies, that this is a topic for the nurse.
With the cup, I just want to say that I heard about it too, but I like it because it's reusable. You think of it like with pads and tampons, it's very wasteful. Since, like, you have to, like, throw it away. But they are making, like, have you seen, like, the underwears where, like, you can, like, have it? Mm-hmm. So that's also nice because then you can just wash it and it's, like, reusable. But, yeah, I did hear about
it. Okay, I would be interested to know if a man created the tampon because it can be detrimental to your health, especially if you leave it in for too long.
Yeah,
and I think I would be interested to know if a woman came up with the cup because I feel like that circumvents like toxic shock syndrome because if you leave a tampon in for too long, it could end up hurting you.
I saw this thing where this man invented like gloves for when you change your pad or something as if you would need it. Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Men have no idea what they shouldn't be creating stuff for us in the first place.
That brings up like another thing I saw where this woman she was trying to find like these yoga pants that would actually fit her curves and not show like I don't know how to say this without like.
Like it wouldn't,
and so she was able to create a design where it fitted her waist and it was actually comfortable to wear, and I was just like, see, that's what we need, and not men trying to figure out what women actually need.
Another thing I see a problem in the community is like body image and like body dysmorphia. I feel like it also needs to be talked more. I know a few, like, join groups, like, Rocks, mm-hmm. Or just, like, have a conversation with girls. I know that magazines are being more exclusive. Like, I know Fenty with, why am I forgetting her name? Brianna. I know she's, like, being more inclusive in her own line. Like, it shows, like, women that are plus size and also men that are plus size in, like, her magazines and everything. So I like the idea of, that they're being more inclusive and just like destroying the idea of like this perfect body that you need to be, especially with women, since we're always pressured to be a certain way, or else we're not as valued more. So as a closing question, what is advice you would give to yourself or someone that's like our age, like in high school?
I would say that you shouldn't get set up into a path that you have to follow because you're a girl, right? That I have to go to college and get married and have children, and this is the path for happiness, because it is not. That to have in mind that every person has their own path that they are going to be building for themselves, and that path can be successful the same way.
Hey guys, it's Jade. International Women's Day is March 8th. What is International Women's Day, you may ask? Here's what internationalwomensday.com has to say. International Women's Day is a global day celebrating the social,
economic, cultural, and political achievements of women. The day also marks a call to action for women's accelerating equality. Now, what are you going to do on March 8th to help make the world a better place for gender equality? Go to internationalwomensday.com for some ideas.
Some people think that because you're a woman, you are expected, right, to get married and then to have kids, and then you will be happy. But that is not true. Every one of you will have the opportunity to have all that, but just let life guide you, God guide you on what your career or your life is going to be. Just leave the opportunities that life is giving you every single day. If it's giving you the opportunity to study, study. Maybe you get to meet the prince of your life and then get married. But if not, don't let anybody tell you this is the path that you have to follow to be happy. You need to build on your own, and it's going to be successful, even if it's different from other people.
Kind of going off of what she said, sometimes we look at social media and we think everything we see is true, and not using that as a means of comparing your life to somebody else, thinking, well, she's done all these things by this age, and I haven't done half of what she's done. She's probably super happy and nothing goes wrong. I think it's fine to enjoy social media, but remember, we can always project the idea that we want people to see of ourselves. And that if you kind of take everything to heart, or a lot of social media has a lot of Photoshop on there too, you can take all those images, all these things to heart, and sometimes it's just better to step back. That's why I only have like one social media account across all the things, because I also just got tired of all the things I saw happening on there. So I have a timer where it says, oh, you've been on here for about 45 minutes. That usually means I didn't do what I was supposed to do. I was supposed to spend less than that. I shouldn't have got the warning. But just to remember, social media can really be detrimental to your health. In fact, they've linked it to depression. So just keep in mind how much you consume and what you're consuming on social media.
And I guess I would say that to always remember that you have more power than you think you do. I think it was Alice Walker that said something like, the most common way that people lose power is by thinking they don't have any. And so I think that we're more powerful than we think we are, and we have to look to those women who have been great examples for us. I mean, I think of my mom and my grandma who, you know, raised me to know that I could do whatever I wanted to do. So just remember that you have a voice. It's important to develop it, and you have more power than you think you do.
Gosh, I shouldn't go last, but I guess two things, and everyone's going to cringe, but we really are better together. And I think Ms. Dixon said it earlier, but like when one woman is successful, then that helps all of us. Yes. And I think it's really important for us to foster these relationships and to not feel jealous or threatened. But that when we are supportive of one another, then we all win. And I think I can end with that, right? That is our theme of the year.
That's right.
Yes. So. Women.
Good job. We can pull it together.
Okay, well, I just want to say thank you to all of you for coming to our podcast and talking about this special topic to all of us in this month that we're going to celebrate Women's History. So thank you.
Thank you.
You and me are free to be you and me.